Let's start with the praise break moment. It's Black History Month, and as I stated, we're going to try to use some praise breaks from our Black history. And today's praise break comes from a man known as James Mercer, also was born James Mercer, but also goes under the name of Langston Hughes. Langston Hughes was a poet, a writer, the leading figure of the Harlem Renaissance. And after his first poem was published in 1921, his first book of poetry followed 5 years later in 1926. He's one of the first Black Americans to earn a living as a writer. Hughes went on to compose many more works of poetry and plays that center the 20th century African-American experience and remain influential today. As I stated, he's an innovator of this new literary art form called jazz poetry. Langston Hughes is this leader, this writer, this great orator. And in one of his books, he writes one of his stories, poems or stories, he writes the book, Thank You, Ma'am, Thank You, Sir, written by, Thank You, Ma'am is written by Langston Hughes. It's a story about a kid named Roger, whom it depicts of having a dirty face, and he attempts to rob a woman by the name of Mrs. Jones because he wanted to buy some blue suede shoes. So he intends to rob her, but she refuses. She refuses to give up her purse. And as she doesn't give up her purse, she chastises him. And eventually, as you go into the story, she begins to take him home and teach him some things. And so the theme of Thank You, Ma'am are about second chances, trust, generational relationships, poverty, and dignity. Miss Jones provides a second chance to Roger, who tried to rob her. And by trusting and teaching him, he learns that being poor doesn't mean living without dignity. She could have turned him in. She could have gave him up to the cops. His whole life would have changed forever. But instead, she chose to be kind and to teach him. And I just think that there is a praise break in that. When we think about the days of old, when thank you, ma'am, and thank you, sir, and yes, ma'am, and yes, sir, was a norm. Being that I'm in the healthcare industry and work in customer service, it is now not lawful for you to refer to someone in customer service as ma'am or sir because of the transgender nature of a person, the what a person could be. We can't even refer to it anymore. Think about how the times have changed so much that we can't even refer to the things that we did in the past to honor those, if you will. Anyway, so even though she could have turned him in, what's our shout? What is it that we can get from this Langston Hughes story, Thank You, Ma'am? We certainly can get from this story that we ourselves have been guilty of trying to rob. Yeah, we've tried to rob. Maybe not physically. Maybe you're not a physical crook, but I believe we've tried to rob God. We've tried to rob God of the praise that he's due. Many of us have taken credit for things that he has done like we did it. Yeah, we've robbed him. We've robbed him. There are things that we have robbed God. We haven't given him his due. We haven't given him what he deserved. And we've robbed him of what was his. And I'm so grateful that even though we robbed him, he didn't do us dirty. He didn't turn us in. Yet he still teaches. He still keeps us. He still holds us. He still owns us as his own, even though we haven't done what we want. So I just wonder, for our praise break, can we just say thank you? Thank you to him. And thank you, like even in the midst of this, Roger had to come to the realization that this woman was a figure that could help him. And she taught him how to have dignity in the face of everything that he thought he did not have. You can take everything from me, but you can't take away my dignity. And so I wonder, is there a shout for anybody who can remember the days of old when we learned from our elders, when they chastised us, and we're here where we are today because of that thing, that chastisement that we got, and we listened to them and listened to their stories and listened to them tell us that we were better than what we were doing. And how many of us really did better? And so I wonder, is there anybody here that could not be a robber or can be just be a Roger and thank God and say thank you?